Coming up this week on the season premiere of Wildcat Fastbreak, the Northwestern basketball teams hit the road to open up Big Ten conference play. We've got the highlights and the reaction from the Wildcats. Plus, we'll take you along as the men take the team-building trip of a lifetime. All that and more this week on Wildcat Fastbreak. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to another season of Wildcat Fast Break. I'm Dave Ennett, coming to you from Welsh Ryan Arena, the home of Northwestern basketball. Both the Northwestern men's and women's teams are off to great starts this season. Both opened Big Ten conference play last week. And we start with Chris Collins and the men at Nebraska for their Big Ten opener. That's our Nissan big game.
And we welcome you inside the Pinnacle Bank Arena in Lincoln, Nebraska, where this afternoon we have the Big Ten Conference opener between 12-1 Northwestern and the 8-5 Nebraska Cornhuskers. Demps going to the basket.
You'll see a lot of that tonight. Demps is relentless, likes to attack the glass. He will continue to go until the baskets begin to fall.
Bryant McIntosh against freshman Jack McVeigh.
That's tough. You know, that's where he's really improved his game the most, which is being able to create off of the bounce. We knew he could shoot the basketball.
One for Northwestern. And now Falzone in the corner, and he answers right back. Aaron Falzone has hit three threes, and it's going to cause Tim Miles to call a timeout.
Yeah, I mean, just having that weapon of Aaron out on the floor, teams are putting so much attention onto Bryant and Trey, and rightfully so, because they make a lot of things happen for us. So if we can get our shooters, and Aaron specifically as one of our top guys going, it really opens the floor for other guys, for our inside game, for our driving, and for our guards to have more opportunities to make plays.
Derek Harden posting up on Mora. And if they can get some buckets from Derek Harden scoring like that, Damian, all of a sudden, you look at this Northwestern team and they might be able to weather the storm without Alex Olaf for a couple of weeks. Now Demps pulls up for a three to answer. That's good.
Wow.
Parker's gonna race it across. Leaves it off White. It's good. And that brings us to the half. Steal by Parker. Nebraska's up 12. Timeout, Northwestern.
When you're on the road and the crowd's going nuts, we called timeout. And it was kind of a moment of truth for that game. You know, were we going to roll over and accept the loss, accept what was happening, or were we going to try to fight back and make a game of it? And we came out of that timeout and put together a really good 4 minutes, hit some shots, got some stops, were able to get ourselves back in the game and put ourselves in a position those last 5 minutes to make enough plays to win the game.
McIntosh off target and pardon the two-handed slam.
The young man came to play.
McIntosh across for Northwestern. Ooh, feeding nice Pardon, what a look.
Yeah, it was really amazing to have a freshman who was planning on sitting out the whole year come in with really one game under his belt and play on the road in a tough environment, first Big Ten game, and to be that active, to be that confident, to make score 20 points in the second half, I think 6 offensive rebounds. He was all over the place, and his energy brought so much to our team, and I was really proud of him, and it shows how hard he's been working even while he's been sitting out, that when he was called upon, he was ready to produce in a big way.
They pick up a big win on the road to begin Big Ten Conference play. The Wildcats, their best start in school history now.
So the Cats win it 81-72 with Derek Pardon leading the way with a brilliant performance, pouring in 28 points and pulling down 12 rebounds in his Big Ten debut. After the game, Pardon talked about the victory and getting the unexpected chance to play this season.
Yeah, like I just said, I'm blessed. I'm happy Coach Collins gave me the opportunity to come out here and play. And my teammates just brought me in with open arms, and that's what I did. I played my game. Just always playing hard. That's what I do every day throughout my whole life. I always played hard, and that's what I did. Saw Nebraska got a little tired, so I kept on pushing up the level and intensity. And that's why I felt won the game.
On Saturday, the Wildcats returned back home for a showdown with fourth-ranked Maryland. Let's check out the highlights.
The Northwestern Wildcats are on the air tonight from Welsh Ryan Arena in Evanston. Big Ten basketball. It's the Northwestern Wildcats and the Maryland Terrapins.
You know, those are the nights you dream about. Saturday night, big game feel, top five team in the country coming in. The place is packed, you know, in purple, cheering for us. It was an unbelievable college basketball environment, and I know our guys loved, you know, playing in front of the fans and the way they came out in full force. And hopefully that's something that can become the norm as we go through the Big Ten.
Lumpkin, short quarter right. Lumpkin driving, spins, turns, put it up, got it. Sanjay Lumpkin with a reverse pivot, 360, got it to go. Really cold from long range. Suleiman hits a three. And it's 33-14.
I thought we got uncharacteristically out of character offensively and forced some tough turnovers, which then led to them getting out and having fast break layups and a couple open threes. And once they were able to get that separation, if you give a team like that a double digit lead, it's incredibly hard to climb out of that hole.
So the inbounds, Dodd was a little, or Stone rather, a little lackadaisical, lost sight of it. McIntosh scoops one over his head and scores. And there's a block by Van Zegren. Lindsey gets it. Bouncing, McIntosh, he scores!
He was throwing a lob pass.
I thought that was a pass and it went in.
Look at Chris. Chris is
47-32.
Yeah, I think the second half showed a lot about our team. Again, you're down by 20 points against a great team who's playing at a really high level. You know, how do you respond to that? And I was really proud of our fight coming out of the locker room. I thought we tried to make a couple runs there to get it in manageable situations. We wanted to try to get it to single digits so we could put a little bit of game pressure on them with the crowd. And we got it to 14, I think 13 one time, and had a couple shots that really I think would have maybe made a little bit of a push, but we weren't able to knock them down, and they were able to make the plays. But overall, it wasn't as much about us not doing the things versus what Maryland did really well, and hopefully we can use that game as a great learning experience headed into this week.
Two coaches exchange handshakes. This ball game is over, and so is the Wildcats' 10-game winning streak and their 13-game home winning streak.
Tough one for the Cats as they fall 72-59 at Welsh Ryan Arena. Bryant McIntosh paced the Cats with 17 points and was an assist shy of a double-double with 9 assists. Coming up after the break, we turn our attention to the Wildcat women. Joe McEwen's nationally ranked Cats open with a pair of tough tests. That's up next.
TLX from Acura.
Visit your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Acura dealer for attractive offers on the TLX.
Are you ready to go? How's the hip?
I think you know that we have to take this one plant at a time. It's really the only way that Eunice Feldman knows how to garden. We have got a lot of great bulbs, strong perennials. I am looking forward to a great season and can't wait to get back out onto the field. So thank you and good night.
The place that impacts you every day is the place you call home. Which is why we've made your home our home too. Northwestern Medicine now offers world-class care at over 60 locations close to you to make an impact every day.
Hi,
Hi, I'm Rob Panter, owner of Evanston Subaru and Skokie, inside Welsh Shrine Arena at Northwestern University. I'm proud to sponsor Northwestern Athletics again this season with our award-winning lineup of all-wheel drive Subarus, like the new Subaru Outback, the Subaru Forester, and the Subaru Crosstrek. Evanston Subaru and Skokie on Oakton at McCormick.
How long does it take to change the game of basketball? Days, years, decades? How about 0.4 seconds? All of a sudden, big ain't so big no more. Small ain't so small. The step back three is the new dunk. Follow through is the new poster. Range is the new hang time. How long to change the game of basketball? 1 second or less.
Game is tied at 67. Cats will hold for the final shot, try to win it. We're down to 9, down to 8. Depths with 7, with 6, with 5. Depths stops, puts up a jumper. Good! That's the ball game. The Wildcats win! The Wildcats win! An unbelievable game.
If I could have any meal before a game, it would be PB&J with a tall glass of chocolate milk.
French fries and a hamburger. My favorite food. Promise it won't slow me down.
My favorite pregame meal is bread, just because I love bread and it's a simple meal.
If I could eat anything before a game, it would have to be chicken wings, but obviously I can't do that because I would probably throw up. So it's a sad day to be Chris Johnson before a basketball game because I really love chicken wings.
Usually chicken, pasta, salad, and if it's in the morning, y'all have some scrambled eggs, a little bit of bacon, some fruit. Try to keep it light for the game.
My favorite pregame meal is whatever they give us, but if it's lasagna, that's my favorite because I like meat and cheese.
My favorite snack to have before a game are Krispy Kreme donuts, but Coach can't know, so don't tell him. It's a secret.
Welcome back to Wildcat Fast Break. Time now to look at the Northwestern women, who began the week ranked 14th in the nation after starting the season 11-1. They went on the road to open Big Ten play Thursday at Penn State. Let's get to the highlights.
Good afternoon from State College, Pennsylvania, where today the Northwestern Wildcats women's basketball team opens Big Ten play against the Penn State Nittany Lions. Now here's Deary across the timeline. Lion with it on the left wing. She'll fire a three. That's good. Maggie Lion opens the account for the Wildcats. Coffee quickly back the other way at the elbow. Steps through. Little floater rolls around it in.
It was really a game of runs that I felt like we got off to a terrific start, up 16-9. And, then we really struggled with rebounding the basketball and, just had some breakdowns on defense. And Penn State made us pay.
And it's A.G. has it at the elbow. She'll find Tania Page. Down low to A.G. Nice cut that time from Peyton Witted. Deary to Lyon, top of the key. Gets a screen from Coffee. Inman, left corner three. She'll put it up. She'll put it in. Kristen Inman has her first three-pointer of the game.
Oh, I think we just broke some things down. Yeah, it was one of those technical games where you got to switch here. You got to screen here. You got to do this or do that. And I think that was really our focus at halftime because we were doing some really good things, too. We just missed some shots. We took 33 three-pointers, which is not what we do. And I think we got caught up in that a little bit, and it hurt us.
Lion, she'll take a left-wing three. That's good. Maggie Lion will be big for the Wildcats in the second half. Deary, inside, back out. Rohde, right corner, three, rolls in. Deary to Rohde, left wing. Back to Deary, top of the key, 15 on the shot clock. Deary takes the three, it's good! Ashley Deary! Ashley Deary will inbound. She's forced to just toss it up to Coffee, working down low, fading away left-handed. That was nice!
Third quarter, we played well. We went into the fourth quarter, I think up by two. So you feel like, even though you're on the road and they were playing well, that we kind of got control of the game back. And to Penn State's credit, they made big shots, big plays down the stretch, and we just couldn't respond to that last run. But hard fought game.
The clock will run out, and a final from State College. The final score, Penn State 79, Northwestern 72.
Final score, Penn State wins it 79-72. Nia Coffey led the team with 20 points and 12 rebounds, while Ashley Deary notched a double-double, scoring 12 and handing out 10 assists.
Welcome on into Walsh Ryan Arena. I'm Ari Ross alongside Ben Gorn here on Minions Day at Walsh Ryan Arena as Northwestern women's basketball takes on Nebraska. Inman over to Lyon. Get back to Inman. Seven on the shot clock. Inman hoists up a three and that one's in. 3-2 Northwestern with 8:06 to go. Nebraska gives it in to Shepherd at the high post. That's stolen though by Ashley Deary. Ashley Deary pushing Terrio, trying to chase down, but not able to get there. And Deary lays it in, and Nebraska Kaniori will call a timeout. Jonas has checked in for the Cats. He's swinging over to Inman near side. Finds Lyon for an open three, and she knocks it down. 15-2 with 5:11 to go in the first.
We preached after the Penn State game. We addressed things that we thought we were a lot better at in practice, and our players responded. They responded to our coaching staff, to me, and more importantly to each other. You know, and I think the Nebraska game, we just played with great poise, great confidence. Again, being at home really helped. Minion Day really helped, you know. Crowd was great, it was a lot of fun.
Fires it over to Deary. Deary now guarded by Clark. Finds Inman for a wide open three, and she knocks it down. Going around the paint. Fires over to a wide open Romeo, who hoists up a three. That one off the back iron, rebounded by Inman.
To have a plus 11 rebounding stat against Nebraska is really important for us. They have a big front line. They're a plus rebounding team for the season, and you know, over the years they've been a really good rebounding team. So I thought we took on the challenge, really accepted it, and you know, if we could address that all year in the Big Ten, you know, we'll be really competitive, because if we can rebound the basketball, we know we can score.
Line up top, Kristen Inman, crossover left, gets to the foul line, kick out, left wing three, Ashley Deary, nothing but net. Solid offensive execution, Northwestern's lead is 25. Top of the key, Lyon, left wing Deary, inside to Nia Coffey, spin move, lefty layup, good, and one. Nia Coffey, a tough turnaround, Jay with the contact, she gets it to go anyway. What a move by the junior. 7:41, Rometary gets her pocket picked by Ashley Deary, all the way out in front of everyone and lays it home.
You know, when you coach Ashley Deary, she's capable of dominating games on the defensive end. And, you know, we can get her to do that, you know, like what happened against Nebraska. It's a devastating weapon.
Nia Coffey, top of the key, elbow kick out. Left corner three, Ashley Deary, yes sir. Wide open look for Deary, that's worth 3 points. Northwestern's lead is 19. Gets it to Maggie Lyon. Baseline drive, jump stop, kick out, top of the key three for Kristen Inman, nothing but net. Up top, Maya Jonas. Jonas hands off Inman, gets inside, kick out, left corner three. Nia Coffey likes it and drains it. Nia Coffey, 23 points and 16 boards. What a day for her. That is your final at Welsh Ryan Arena. Northwestern handles business and beats Nebraska down 85-62.
So the Cats bounce back in impressive fashion. Ashley Deary, the nation's leader in steals, notched 8 more to go with 15 points and 8 assists. And as she has all season, the conference's leading rebounder dominated the glass as Nia Coffey brought down 17 rebounds to go with her 25 points. And afterwards, she talked about the matchup with Nebraska.
We just really wanted to focus on our defensive pressure, and it really started with Ashley and Inman just playing really hard on Terrio. They did an awesome job. And then we just wanted to match that and really focus on their post as well.
When Wildcat Fast Break continues, this summer the Northwestern men took a 10-day trip of a lifetime. We'll take you to Spain with the Cats next.
TLX from Acura.
Visit your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Acura dealer for attractive offers on the TLX.
Making the everyday feel every day again. Isn't that the point of world-class care? At Northwestern Medicine, we combine the latest research with listening and understanding, leading to breakthroughs that make an impact every day. Northwestern Medicine. Impact every day.
Scotty Lindsay the rebound. First miss tonight for Suleiman from the field. Demps driving and rejected. Jake Lehman got back defensively. Suleiman with some friends, and now McIntosh the steal. Back and forth we go. McIntosh blocked by Lehman. Lindsay, no. Suleiman, the bounce. Carter rejected by Van Severin. Wow. Alley-oop. Oh, he threw it in.
What in the world just happened there? Holy smokes.
Welcome back to Wildcat Fast Break, everybody. This past August, the Northwestern men's basketball team took a 10-day trip to Spain. They played five games, and they did plenty of sightseeing. But the real importance of the trip was team building. We take a look at the highlights in our Northwestern Medicine Inside Look.
Tonight we're going to Madrid. Flight time tonight, 6 hours, 32 minutes.
Every team is allowed every 4 years to take a foreign trip. You know, for me, I wanted this trip, I wanted it to be used for a number of different things. You know, not only to improve as a basketball team, because that's a big advantage. You know, the other thing that it can do really well is it can be a great team bonding experience.
Interesting to see how big soccer is really like over here. It's even bigger than our football back in America. So, you know, going to Real Madrid Stadium and seeing all the stuff they have in their museums and locker room, even the field, is kind of like ridiculous.
This is nice. This is nice.
This is our veteran group.
This is how we do it.
Right. Everyone has to rebound. Yep. They got men, so yep. They're going to be pushing.
Gotcha. Everybody rebound. Everybody rebound.
The games are fun, you know, but the fact that we got to come down here, like all the memories that I got to spend with my teammates and the bonding moments, those opportunities are like once in a lifetime. I don't really think many people get to ever do that, you know, so I think that's what I really take back with me. You know, we're basically spending all the time with us, you know, with everyone else and, you know, our families and each other. You know, while other teams are kind of at home, they're kind of away from basketball, kind of chilling out, you know, we spent the 10 extra days practicing, and now we got to come here for 10 more days. So it's all like we really get to learn each other and we're really building a lot of chemistry.
You can see more from the trip and the Wildcat summer in a four-part series entitled The Foundation, available now at nusports.com. That's going to do it for our first episode of Wildcat Fast Break for this season. A reminder, for tickets to see Chicago's Big Ten team, go to nusports.com or call 888-GO-PURPLE. Now for the coaches, Chris Collins and Joe McEwen, I'm Dave Ennett. We'll see you right back here next week. Thanks for being with us, and as always, go Cats.